Well, it's October 11th and I have my girlfriend Danielle behind the camera, and we came out here to pick some sheep's head, also known as Maitake, or the scientific name is Grifola Frondosa. There's the size of it. It's a fairly young one. I've been watching this one for at least a week or so. They do grow pretty fast. It's best to pick them when they're young. This is an old white oak stump, and as you can see, here's another smaller one. It's not quite ready. It's still got a lot of growth to it. There's another one over by that tree also, and we're going to show you, because they can also grow by live trees. Either one, you can find them by the dead oak stumps or the trees. They usually grow about this far. They can be tucked up inside, and they can color in variation to almost a white, a real light white color. I've actually found one earlier this year. As you can see in this one here, the coloration is a lot different. This is typical color here. They can also get real light gray. It's polypore. There's no gills or anything under the bottom. Best time to know when to pick them is under the bottom. You can see they get real white underneath here, and this is where the spores will be. When you start seeing a lot of holes and it kind of gets spongy down here, that's a sign that it's a hair late, but you can still pick them off and scrape that stuff off here. But this is a young one. This is a pretty good size to pick. You can pull these off. You can cut them. I prefer to cut them. Most people just rip them off the ground. But the bottom side, you really can't eat. And as you can see, there's a tube right here, and that goes down into the ground, and this is what where they grow from. There you can see that is a really good specimen right there. The whole mushroom is practically edible. You're going to want to cut this chunk out. And the thing is, it's best to pick them when they're smaller, because the bigger they are, the harder they are to clean. As you can see, there's all different kinds of little crevices and stuff that bugs and debris and dirt, and especially this is out in the open, so this one here is going to be pretty easy to clean. And they have the leaflets here. Well, we're going to take this home, we're going to cook it, prepare it, and eat it. Well, here's the other one by the oak tree, and they're growing off the roots of the oak tree, so I mean they're sprouting up a ways away. Here's where one was picked about a week ago. I didn't pick it. Somebody else got to it before I did. But this one here also, we'll cut this one off. There you can see the tube roots that have gone down into the ground. And you know, you can pick these and just pull them off, but I like to cut them to keep these intact, because sometimes you can rip them out if they're in the real loose soil. But as you can see, they can be somewhat of a pain to clean. But we're going to also take this one. You can vacuum seal these and freeze them, and they can last a pretty good long time, and you just thaw them out and they'll be just like new. All right, so the first thing what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start cutting some of this really bad, completely covered in dirt. And I already saw a couple bugs in there. Now on the older ones, this stem is going to get tough, but in these younger ones, you can't eat the stem. Now as you can see, these leaflets here, these are going to be good, so you can just cut these off. Now this can be thrown away, and we're also going to come around through this side and cut these bad places off here. Okay, then what you can do is you can just kind of rip this into pieces here. And this makes it a little bit easier for cleaning. As you can see, we got a little bug in there right now. And so we're going to just kind of break these up a little bit, just run them over real quick with some water and shake them up a bit, get all the dirt and debris and the bugs out of them, and then we'll go from there. Okay, so right now we just have what we're gonna eat for right now cut up. We still have a lot more to go, but we're gonna do some cooking. We're gonna actually cut this up and clean it, and we're gonna vacuum seal this stuff. But this is what we're gonna eat right now. Okay, what you're gonna need is obviously your sheep's head and one clove of minced garlic, some butter, salt and pepper, and some olive oil. Melt the butter and oil over medium heat. Then you can throw in your garlic, cook that for about 15 seconds. All right. Drop the heat down a little bit to medium low, and add a little bit of salt and pepper. And you can cook these for a rather long time and they're still going to have their good flavor. And just cook it on medium to medium high heat. You can see the moisture coming out. You just don't want to, if it doesn't bring out a lot of moisture, you want to drop it down a little bit so you don't burn your garlic. And if you get a lot of liquid, you can drain it out, but it's best not to put a giant pan full of sheep's head in, because you're going to get a lot of moisture and water drainage out of these mushrooms. But you can cook them about 5 minutes on each side, or you can cook them up to 10 minutes on each side if you like them a little bit crispier. You're not going to hurt it too bad, but like I said, you do this enough and you'll know pretty much when they're done. These things take just a little bit longer to cook, and we cook them just about till they're a little golden around the edges. Time to eat.
Good.
Mm-hmm. What's it taste like?
A mushroom.
Mushroom. Mm-hmm. Closer to the chicken of the woods or a morel?
It tastes more like a morel.
Yeah, these are good. Really can't explain the taste of it. You'd almost have to go out there and find one for yourself and cook it up. Tastes amazing. Almost as good as morels, I think. Really good. Plus you get a lot more. A little bit different texture than a morel. A little bit thicker. Almost like a crunchier, meatier type of a mushroom, because you know it's thicker and they are really good. So there you go, hen of the woods, or maitake, or sheep's head, or ram's head, or Grifola Frondosa. I got my little freezer zip packs here. I'm just gonna, these are just padded dry. I'm just gonna put them in here. Kind of even them out. I don't want a big bulge in the bag. Got this from a friend, so it looks pretty easy. There we go. Here is some chicken of the woods. You just need this outer fringe here. Small 1-inch pieces. Danielle's gonna try the first bite.